Good afternoon, everyone. We're obviously delighted to be here at last. As it says in the programme, it's taken over 100 years to actually get to this point that we've got a training facility. So I think a big thanks to Richard Scudamore from the Premier League, Jed Roddy. We've got our guests from the council, partners in this project, which is fantastic. We've got our contractors, everybody that's taken part and helped to get us to where we are today. We spent over £6 million on this project, and obviously we're delighted to be where we are and finally get the official opening. So I'm going to ask Richard to officially open our facility, and then we'll carry on with the proceedings. So thank you, Richard.
Yeah, Hugh, thank you. Thank you for the welcome we've had here. This is a momentous day really for the club to open this fantastic facility. I've been coming down to Swansea for a long time. Coming down when I was chief executive of the Football League back in the late 1990s, and went to the Vetch and various other things, and to see what's happened to this club over the last few years, specifically since it retained its or got its Premier League status, to see the investment that the directors have sensibly made, because there is no point in getting to the Premier League, there's no point in getting the financial rewards that go with being in the Premier League if you don't invest some of it to leave something behind. And I've obviously, looking at this today, I've been over to Fairwoods to see the new development over there as well this afternoon. And really, it's going to be fantastic. No matter what happens to Swansea Football Club in the future, at least those legacy things will be there, hopefully, to build on and build success. So well done to Hugh, well done to the fellow directors for backing this type of facility. I know Michael will be much appreciated with all the facilities he's got to play in. And it's what's needed in modern football in order to coach and bring the players on. So it's great to open the facility. I'm going to do it now. I think somebody's rather set me a bit of a tripwire. I don't know what I'm supposed to. I've probably got to unravel all this first, have I? Or something.
Just pull them apart.
Or just pull them apart.
Yeah.
Okay, let's just pull them apart. You ready? Here we go. It's opened. Well done. You're on the
Very good. Well, Richard, we heard the opening of the new training facility in Landore, and I'm sure you'll agree it's an excellent new facility as well.
Oh, it's absolutely brilliant, isn't it? Everything about it, from, you know, obviously the building is one thing, but the most important thing is out there. The pitches and the surface that the players have got to train on and coach on is first class.
There's £6 million spent on this development, which is a lot of money for Swansea, but I'm sure the benefits you reap from it is, you know, it's worth the money.
Yeah, I mean, as you know, a Premier League club now gets somewhere like £62-63 million just for being in the league this season. But the directors of the club have got to be complimented. They've invested wisely. It doesn't all go on players and players' wages, though some of that's important. To actually reinvest some of that money in facilities lasts, you know, leaves a huge legacy for the club for the future. And it's the club are entirely well set up with facilities like this.
When we look at the Premier League, obviously the attraction is there with the big name players, the massive transfer fees, etc. But it all really starts with facilities like this, doesn't it?
Everybody's trying to do the same thing. Everybody wants a local gem, you know, who's, you know, a young boy who's somewhere living or being born and raised within a few miles from here, to actually want it, first of all. But secondly, obviously, good enough to really come and develop. And every club wants a homegrown player. Everybody wants a club born, you know, as I say, locally, come up locally to be a local hero. And that's the thing most clubs would like to see. And that's why, again, facilities like this are important.
It's been nice to see Swansea doing things right on the pitch,
yep,
as a football team and as a business as well. And nice to see them on the training pitch now, doing it finally right, as the chairman rightly pointed out, first training ground in 100 years.
It's a very well-run club. You know, it's been well-run for a number of years. It's got them into the Premier League. They've done sensible things. They have a football philosophy that runs throughout the club. You can tell that. You can see that. As I say, it's got that degree of supporter ownership as well, in terms of, you know, the community feel engaged with the club. And now I suppose all this really is the last piece in that jigsaw, in terms of training facilities, in terms of youth facilities, in terms of development facilities. So yeah, well set up.